You might have come across a green tree frog in your time. They're generally out at night time, but they're also known as dunny frogs because they don't mind making a home inside a toilet. But lately, these dunny frogs have been turning up dead. It's happening right across Australia, along the east coast, down to Tasmania, South Australia, and the southeast corner of WA. Exactly what's killing them is a mystery. We may not realise it, but frogs are all around us. There are more than 240 native species in Australia, and more than 30 of them are threatened with extinction. They might keep out of sight, but their presence in our waterways is super important. Frogs are considered the canaries in the coal mine. If they die, it could lead to the collapse of entire ecosystems.
So what happens when frogs disappear is the streams and ponds clog up with algae, and all the other animals in particular that rely on frogs for food start to disappear.
Which is why right now biologists are extremely worried, because since the start of winter, more than 1,500 reports of dead and dying frogs have come through. And not just one or two at a time, but dozens at a single location.
What's happening right now is definitely not normal. It's kind of horrifying. The scale of this event in terms of the number of frogs, the number of species, and how widespread it is across Australia, it is potentially devastating. And so we are working around the clock to try and get to the bottom of this.
Green tree frogs seem to be the worst affected. They make up about 2/3 of the reported deaths, but it's also affecting other species, including the cane toad.
So the number of dead frogs that we're finding, those are just the tip of the iceberg.
So what's killing them?
The number one suspect for what's going on right now is disease. Frogs have been battling their own pandemic for decades, and it's caused by something called the amphibian chytrid fungus.
But chytrid has been around for decades. The last devastating outbreak was back in the 80s. Pathologists reckon that this time around, there could be another disease at play that's killing off the amphibians in unprecedented numbers.
We know that a fairly high proportion of the animals that we've been able to examine do have chytrid fungus infection, but we're finding some animals that don't have any evidence of fungal infection.
Ordinarily, biologists would get out into the field to work out what's going on, but it's not been an ordinary year. Lockdowns across much of the East Coast has meant locals have played a hugely important role in the investigation. Citizens doing their bit for science using email or an app on their phone.
Best thing to do is to email a frog ID, and there's pretty rapid response on that email chain. If you find one that's dead, we'd definitely like you to pick it up through a plastic Ziploc bag and write on the Ziploc bag the date and location, and then you'll get further instructions after sending the email.
The important part is, if it's alive, don't touch it. And if it's dead, don't use your bare hands. Use a plastic Ziploc bag to pick it up, and then it might seem grim, but put it in your freezer to preserve it until local vets or a team of biologists can get their hands on it.
Based on what we've seen so far, this affects the frogs incredibly quickly. They tend to be found sick, and within a matter of hours, they've perished. So the sound of silence is the experience of this outbreak. And I guess that's our worry, that we're going to go bushwalking or out in the evening into our back gardens and be faced with silence.
So how can we bring a happier ending to all of this? Well, solving the mystery is key. People are encouraged to take a photo or record the sounds of croaks in their backyards so that the experts can work out where these jumpy little guys can be found. With that and some pretty urgent lab work, it's hoped that the sound of spring across Australia won't be silenced.